What's good, fellas? My name's Andy, and today we're gonna take a look at something I found recently which sparked my interests. I'm sure everyone's heard of Rhino, Ryan Anderson. He was the starting power forward for the Rockets last year, and he's also considered as one of the best shooters at his position. Last season, he averaged 13.6 points a game and attempted about 7 threes a game, making 40% of them, which is a great percentage. He only attempted about 11 field goals a game, so 7 of them being from 3-point land is pretty crazy for a power forward. But that's the type of player he's always been, and he fits into Mike D'Antoni's offense really well. So recently, I saw some stats on ESPN about Ryan Anderson's shooting percentages that really, really shocked me. He played 72 games last season in 2016-17. 36 of those games were at home, and 36 were on the road. In those 36 home games, he averaged just 11 points a game on 33.2% from 3. That's kinda awful, especially since 3-point shooting is basically the only thing he's good at. But then I saw his stats on the road, and they're crazy. In his 36 road games, he averaged 16 points on 46% shooting and 46.5% from 3. How is this even possible? Anderson shoots much, much worse at home than he does on the road. Usually, for most players, it's the opposite. Players are supposed to play better at home, which is why we call it, you know, home court advantage. But even so, the differences between his shooting splits are insane, regardless of what arena he's playing in. That's a 13% difference in his 3-point shooting, and with the amount of games he played last season, it's definitely statistically significant. What's even weirder is that in the 2015-16 season when Anderson was with the New Orleans Pelicans, the opposite happened. On his threes in that season, he shot 40.4% at home in New Orleans and 32.1% on the road. Which makes a bit more sense, I guess, but that's still a pretty big difference. So I tried to do some more research and see if anyone else has talked about Anderson's strange shooting splits. And I came across this Reddit post. I'll put a link in the description below too. Apparently, part of the reason why Anderson shoots so poorly at home is because all of the red colors in the Toyota Center where the Rockets play skew his depth perception. So sometimes Anderson might perceive the basket to be closer or farther than it actually is. Research backs this up as well, as it indicates that color impacts people's depth perception, although it's not that much. The person also mentions that depth perception issues are common among people who are red-green colorblind. Even Tracy McGrady, who used to play for the Rockets years ago, has struggled at times at home, while playing much better on the road. When asked about this, he stated that, "I don't know. There's something about home. I'm really not a big fan of our arena. I'm really not, because the depth perception, the seats are so far back." This is just another piece of information that backs up the theory that Anderson's shooting issues are because of the arena. Even throughout his career, he's never played that well in Houston compared to other arenas. Others believe that it could possibly be because of all the red colors there, but further research shows that it's not because of red. The original post says that he also plays poorly in Chicago, but those stats were actually incorrect. According to another post, he actually plays really well in Chicago. He also has had his best shooting games in Atlanta, which the stadium also has a lot of red colors. So I guess we can say it's not the red that's causing Anderson to shoot poorly. Maybe it just has something to do with what McGrady said, about how the seats were really far back and askew some players' depth perception. It obviously doesn't affect all players though. The other Rockets players like Harden, Ariza, and Gordon all have similar percentages between their home and away games. The only major outlier is Anderson. If we look back even further in his career, his 3-point splits are all kinda random. I mentioned earlier that in 2015-16 he shot 40% from 3 at home and 32% on the road. Which is okay, that's not too bad. But in 2014-15 it was atrocious. He shot 42% at home but just 27% on the road. I'll skip 2013-14 since he only played 22 games because of injuries. In 2012-13, he was pretty consistent though, averaging 38.5% at home and 38% on the road. So yeah, I don't know. Maybe he just likes the New Orleans arena a lot better. It also could be that Anderson is just an inconsistent shooter in general. Throughout his career, he's always been known as a streaky shooter. So it's possible that his 2016-17 season in Houston has nothing to do at all with his perception issues. But we'll see. I mean, he does have a history of not performing that well in that arena. If he continues to shoot this poorly again at home this season, then someone or something will have to change. Or maybe not. The Rockets could just trade him away or something. Alright, anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that short video. I thought this was an interesting but weird topic, so I just wanted to share this with everyone. If you liked it, make sure to leave a thumbs up, and I'll see you next time.